Hey friends, it's time to work on my F-350 project truck again. Where's that called? The junky truck. So I've got a canopy set up to keep me out of the sun because it's going to be 100 to screw that today. And what I'm working on is this wiring. So we're going to rework this harness that goes to the engine. So all this stuff is labeled. We'll get started on that here shortly. And I'm using some Wi-Fi connectors, and then I've got some wire from Wire Barn. This is a nice quality automotive wire. So that's what I'll be using for replacements. And feel free to skip around if you enjoy it. Let me know what you think in the comments. All right, so I've got everything set up. Part of this project is relocating the glove plug controller. I think it's going to go right here. I'm sure I can really get that a little closer. I'm going to bring it down. Yeah, I like that better. Because then I can get the wires above it. Whatever that is. So, I bought this, which has a nice cover, but unfortunately the cover goes where the screws do, and they didn't think through what they were using for screws. So, this down here. If that works, this. See how this goes. And I'm going to use self-tapping screws for this. There are other ways to do it. This is just what I'm doing. These. I'm not sure how well they work, but we'll see. There's fucking wires all over the place in here. Let's see if this shuts. Yeah. We're well clear of that. Alright, that's what we needed to know. Let me go get some other lights. Alright, so, yeah, sorry you guys couldn't get closer, but this just kind of is what it is. I think that's going to go there. Alright, so we're gonna make a little bit of room to work here. start with. Let me go get some stuff out there. These labels are really durable. And I apologize if you were thinking this was going to be a fast video. This is not going to be a fast video. This is going to be a very slow and time-consuming video. These are number 10 wires that are on here. I'll put links to the things I'm using. So, these have removable jaws. White does, but we're gonna hook it up anyway. I gotta take the battery out. All right, so what I'm up to here is I'm unbundling this because I think some of these wires go back and forth, and I want to improve this by simplifying it. This tape is shot anyway, so you know what? Much further than this. Yeah, that's what I expected. So all right, so we can recycle this, I think. Yeah, this is a fusible link. Yeah, so we will recycle. So I think the smaller one will work on this. Yeah, it's tight, but it works. Son of a bitch. Thank you.
right. Wow.
All right, it's time for a little break. Okay, so I've gone ahead and trimmed down the wires that went to the harness and put terminals on them, connected to the glow plug controller, and brought it to here. Yeah, this is coming along quite nicely, and that saved me from having to buy fusible links for this location. So it looks good. I need to start running wires out to the engine, so I'm going to kind of think through this and get started on that. So I think I'm going to tape some of this up before I start working on adding wires to the truck again. So we're going to hook the oil pressure sender up. I got to decide where I want to run the wire. So that one needs to be charged. The other one won't be far behind it. So this wire runs up and over this. And I think that's okay. So I think that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna just stick to this path. And when we rewire the alternator, we will add these wires to the bundle. Now, existing oil pressure sender is here. So we're going to make a junction there. Unfortunately, not anything that is fast or that would be confused with efficient in redoing wiring harnesses. But it will get them right. So, I'm not real happy with that. I was really hoping there would be better overlap there. Thank you. next is going to be the water temperature sensor. Got the red and white wire, which I think is the tack. So let me pick a color for that. We'll get that done. Thank you. Fuel pressure and rewire the solenoids and sensors on the injector pump. In there. Thank you. So that cleaned that up nicely. A little bit of extra wire. That's okay. We'll deal with that later. All right, now we need to make the joint. Now, that's a little loose on this side, but that's okay. It'll be fine on the other side. Alright, so that's one side. That's our fuel cutoff, and that's the high idle solenoid and the high idle, the timing advance high idle solenoid. So what we need to do is bring that to there. Get this all apart. So we got everything wired back up except the water and fuel sensor. Let me see. I think I got this connector. All right. Well, the connector I bought for this doesn't fit, but I took a standard bullet connector and I can make that fit. So that's the solution to that. And that also fits the glow plugs. That's my next project. I'm not going to mess with that right now. I've got to stop and go do some other things. So this is it for today. So today's project was installing the glow plug controller on the firewall or on the fender wall, and then connecting the sensors back for the engine. At this point, it should be startable, but I want to bring the glow plug system back up and running before I go any further with running it. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think in the comments.